In this video, we are going to show you how to install an armor device for a TASKI Swingo 455B.
Four very important things to put in your mind before starting the step-by-step instructions. Number one, armor is powered by 6 volt or 12 volt. 24 volt and higher will burn it up. Number two, armor registers amperage through the little sensor like an amp clamp. Number three, you must orient the sensor properly on a jumper cable to capture both charge and run amps. Number four, you must install the sensor with the little black nub touching the insulation and the arrow pointing toward the positive post. If you orient the sensor wrong, it will not work or will work backward.
The batteries come laying on their side, and it is easier to install the armor device when you rotate the batteries into the upright position. Remove the black positive and negative bracket pieces in the middle. Remove the nut on the negative battery clamp and attach the green wire from the armor device, then tighten the nut back on. Remove the screw from the positive terminal and attach the red wire from the armor device, and then tighten the screw. You should hear a beep when both wires are connected. Put the black bracket pieces back on the battery. Attach the sensor with wire ties to the positive battery cable and charging cable with the arrow pointing towards the positive battery clamp.
If your armor device needs to be activated, establish a data connection. Armor must have battery power for 90 seconds before proceeding. Press and hold maintenance and new batteries button until light flashes, which is about 10 seconds. Wait 20 seconds. Press and hold maintenance until light flashes, about 5 seconds. Wait 20 seconds. Press and hold maintenance and silence buttons until light flashes. Wait 60 seconds. You'll need to cover the sensor with self-sealing tape. Stretch tape while applying to activate sealing. Wrap tape around battery cable in a spiral pattern starting and ending about an inch on either side of the sensor. If you don't have the tape that came with the installation kit, you can use electrician's tape. Leave no gaps in the wrapping. Make sure to completely seal off the sensor. Less than an hour after being applied, the self-sealing tape will become permanently adhered to itself. If you are a tech installing the armor device, photograph the serial number and bag labels. Make sure the photo is clear and readable and attach a photo to your work order.
When finished, turn the battery pack on its side and screw the armor device in place shown here.
Next, you can validate initialization. Run vacuum motor 5 minutes, then hook up to charger. Charge for at least 10 minutes, then disconnect the charger. Validate installation is complete by checking the initialization test tool. It can be found at armordata.com. Enter the MEID number found on the label on the back of the armor box. Click Test MEID. If connectivity and utilization both have a blue check mark next to them, then installation is complete. If connectivity has a red X, make sure you are in an area with a good cell signal. If utilization has a red X, verify the correct placement and orientation of the sensor board. Check that the white arrow is pointing toward the positive battery post. Check that the battery cable is on the correct side of the sensor board. And check that the battery cable is running directly above the black chip located between the four holes. Check for loose wires at the ring terminals. To learn more about armor, visit armordata.com.